my shoes and out the door. Five, I'm alive. Six, seven, eight, feeling great. Nine, gonna shine, life is good. I'm doing fine. Ten, gonna do it right and do it again, yeah. I look into the sky with all the beautiful color, but there's more than just for me, so gonna share it with another. I got to show, to give, let out. I want to sing and shout, take a look and see a beautiful morning that turns into a beautiful evening, and together make a beautiful life. And if you wanna sing.
I've been in here and people are roaring with laughter, so.
It's a dirty show, though.
Well, it's clean dirt.
Forgive me, but the best restaurants of the world are here in Vegas. I mean, you have here the best of the best.
Yes.
So we have many celebrities here. The Harley Madison come over here, and the Usher come over here many often, and the Paris Hilton come here, and Britney Spears came over here like 2 weeks ago.
Boy, I'm dating myself, but it's okay. Nobody else will.
Oh. That's so Vegas. Welcome to That's So Vegas. I'm your host, Christine McKellar, live here at the WCOBM studio, right off the fabulous Las Vegas Boulevard South. And yes, it is a sweltering day today in Las Vegas. 113 and a little humidity just to make us miserable. On a lighter note and a very special note, I have two people here that are close to my heart and will soon become very close to your heart. Right here I have Sarah Stone. Welcome, Sarah.
Thank you, you so much for having me.
Oh, it's just a pleasure. I'm going to introduce Carol McCabe-Joy. Carol's a foster mommy, mostly for Palms.
Yes, absolutely.
Our guest Palm today is little Mr. Redford. And Redford is fully blind. He has cataract. He's also 12 years old. And Carol is nurturing him and getting him to a place where he'll be able to be adopted out. Is that correct?
Right, exactly.
But there's another dog at home that we're going to talk about, which is how you became involved, Sarah. Now, I don't want to confuse people. You're not a doggy psychic. Tell people what you are and how you became, how you went from, of all things, the insurance business into becoming a compassionate healer and, would you call it, listener to dogs?
I say channel healing and animal communication. And I don't need to see them in person. I tune in no matter where they are in the world, and I see everything up here. Like if I was going to read Redford right now, I wouldn't be looking. I'd be going up here because then I get the truth. But when I lived on the East Coast and I was with MetLife, I was in insurance for 16 years.
Oh,
and
wow.
I found somebody that was doing this thing I'd never heard of about 20 years ago, Reiki. Mm-hmm. And so I thought, wow. That really makes me feel so good. How do people live without it? So I thought, well, I think I should take the courses. And I went through all the courses to the master. And I never used it. I really did it for myself because I felt I really needed so much help. And I did.
But can you do it on yourself? I didn't know you could
sure.
do Reiki.
Sure. Okay. Yes, all I right. do healing work on myself
oh,
a
wonderful.
Lot. Yeah. Anyway, when I moved out to Las Vegas with MetLife, I was just always dying to live here. I lasted about 1 year. They had me traveling the 10 Western states in, you know, 3 airports, 3 rental cars, 3 hotel rooms a week.
Mm-hmm.
It was brutal. I thought it was going to kill me. Anyway, I quit. But it's hard to quit a high-paying job.
Mm-hmm.
But I did, and I went.
Oh yeah.
And I went to do pet sitting.
Oh.
So I went probably into about $800 a month.
Pet sitting.
Yeah.
So you've always had an affinity for
oh,
animals.
Oh, gosh, yes.
Okay.
I've liked them way more than people.
Uh-huh.
And during the pet sitting, it dawned on me to try this Reiki thing that couldn't possibly work on animals if they look sad or limping or look sort of
oh,
sick.
Wow.
And they would make changes, but I didn't believe it because it doesn't make sense. And the lady that owned the company, she would say, how did you say it's not working?
Because she could see it.
Yeah, and I could see it too, but it didn't. I couldn't believe it. And
mm-hmm.
I've now been doing this professionally for 16 years, I just started to truly, thoroughly, 100% know what's going on about 2 or 3 years ago and fully trusting this other dimension that comes into work.
Interesting. So are we talking like chakras?
But they're definitely involved. When I open up a healing channel, and I work with my eyes closed, which has an occupational hazard.
Yeah, it could be. Like Pokemon Go is killing people. Yeah. Open your eyes, people.
But so I will look up here, and I'll ask angels just to connect. And now, you know, I used to go through a 20-minute ritual. Now it's just instant. I ask the angels to connect to this animal. And I don't even have to have a name because they know the intention.
Wow.
And so I look and see where the healing work beams of light are going right into what part of the body. And they're usually starting with certain chakra points, which
right.
are almost identical to humans.
Interesting.
Yep. Hmm. And mean the same things.
Wow. Yeah.
So, anyway.
Mm-hmm. You know, we're going to talk more about that in following segments.
Yeah.
And we're going to, of course, talk with Carol in the last segment about the problem dog, because mm-hmm. that was so interesting. When you did, she did a reading on a foster fur
yeah.
that Carol's really been working with, but the dog even bit her, broke her skin. But you did the readings, and we will get back to that. A question that just when I first started looking into your background, uh-huh. so you believe that dogs and animals, we're not just talking dogs and cats, we could be talking horses or, you know, lizards or snakes.
Trees and plants, they all
have souls.
Yeah.
Would you say a dog and a cat have souls?
I'm positive of it. I don't care what anybody says because I've seen it myself. The animals I work with on this side up here, I see the exact same things when I work with them on the other side, which is over here.
The Rainbow
Spirit World.
Bridge?
Yeah.
Okay,
Spirit
that's
World.
Another one we have to talk about.
And the same angels pick up, I call them the pickup angels, pick up the people that pick up the animals, and we go the same place.
Oh.
That I have seen a million and a half times.
That's
over and over and
so
over.
So comforting. Yeah,
I was just going to say,
we'll see them again.
Sultan and Noel and Moses and oh my
Bear Bear and
oh yeah, they'll
carry.
We're bonded to them. But I did want to say how I learned to do it at a distance
mm-hmm.
because I would go to people's house and be bending over and I'd be killing my back. And my life coach at the time, her name's Lori Cloud. So years ago, she said, oh, you have to start doing it at a distance. And I'm like, "How? That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. you can't even, this hands-on can't even work. How could, and I said, what am I supposed to do? She goes, you'll be guided. That was my training.
Well, I guess that kind of makes sense.
That was it.
Dealing with ethereal type.
So I got on the phone with my sister who has had horses up in Washington at the time. And I said, are any of you horses having any issues? I haven't got a clue what I'm doing. But I'm going to try something and just stay on the phone. So we planned a time. One horse had this laminitis, which is so super painful for a horse to stay
in the yeah.
big head. And they usually, a lot of times, have to be put to sleep.
Right.
But people try to save them for sure. But anyway, so she would just hobble. And so we're on the phone for about 2 hours. And first thing I saw was that these angels, without really wings though, coming swarming in around this, in my vision, around this outline of a horse. And I'm like, holy cow.
Wow.
Is this for real? And then they cleared all sorts of parts of the body, and they finally got to the feet. That was like the last part. And but long story short, the next day the horse was out prancing around the pasture.
Oh, wow.
And I was like, first of all, that couldn't have been that. Had to be coincidental.
Oh.
So it took me years
Doubting
to believe
Thomas?
It. Oh, God, yes.
Of, you know, right.
When people are skeptical, they were no more skeptical than I was.
So what was causing the laminitis? Did they ever figure that out? Are you just like, nothing
no.
coming from the owner, nothing coming from the environment?
Yeah.
Could be.
I don't know what was causing it at that time. I was just... That was my first experience,
wow.
and I was so anyway. It's been interesting.
Not, but even more than interesting. I'm glad that we have established that the animals do have souls. They're part of connection with the great,
please.
Ultimate love of the universe. You know, and
very special. To God.
Yeah,
they are.
They are truly. And this thing about the Rainbow Bridge. We're going to have to talk about that even later. I'm going to take give a real quick shout out to my sponsor who keeps me on the air every week, and I know you
Yay.
Guys would just be devastated if I were gone. It's a Red Roof Inn on Paradise. It's across from the Hard Rock Hotel. I always like to throw out there, no resort fees, no parking fees, and girls, you're going to love it. They are pet friendly. I think most Red Roofs are. Don't go away. We're going to be back with Sarah Stone and talk about some really cool stuff. See you in 5 minutes.